Welcome to Advanced REST Client application. Once you open the application, the Request Workspace appears. This is where you build your HTTP or a WebSocket request. The Request Workspace allows you to create as many tabs as you need. By default, the tabs show you the URL of the request. Unless the request is stored in a project, then it shows you the name of the request. The first two things that are mandatory to provide when building an HTTP request is the URL and the operation, also called the HTTP method. You can select one of the standard HTTP operations. For this tutorial, we use the POST operation, which semantically means create a resource operation. In the URL field, start typing the endpoint URL. The autocomplete may show with some suggestions if you have made a request to this endpoint before. The application has a convenient query parameters editor. You trigger it by clicking on the Edit button inside the URL editor. While you are manipulating the query parameters, the value in the URL field changes. This allows you to make sure that the values you enter are the correct ones. You can use the Encode URL button to process the entered values according to the Uniform Resource Identifier specification. This replaces unsupported characters with the corresponding values. Like spaces, they should be replaced with different characters depending on the location in the URL. In the headers editor, you can define HTTP headers by using a convenient form-based editor with auto-suggestions. You don't have to add headers like content length when sending a message, as this header is automatically generated by the transport. You do, however, should define the media type for an HTTP request that can carry a body. You can either do this in the headers editor, or you can go to the body editor, the next tab, and select the MIME type. We select JSON. As you can see, the editor now adds syntax highlighting to the message. This also updates the header value in the headers editor. You can choose various types of body editor. These are the raw input allowing you to provide any text value, the URL form encoded editor that formats the message from the form-based input, the multipart data editor for the multipart message, and the file editor, where you can choose any file to be sent with the request. Each editor holds a separate value for the message type. This means you can switch between different editors and the previous value is restored and used with the request. The authorization editor allows you to define various authorization strategies for the request. You can even define multiple strategies to be applied to the same request at once. Choose the authorization strategy in the selector. Remember to enable the strategy or it won't be applied to the request. For OAuth 2, you can press the Request Access Token button to initialize the authorization process. The application will also do this automatically when sending a request and the token is not yet set. The subsequent calls to the same endpoint will not require getting a new token, as the application already have it. The request actions allow you to define a logic that is executed before and after the HTTP request. You can define actions like setting a cookie, deleting a cookie, or setting a variable. You can grab values from the response and use them in the action. We have another video about request actions, so subscribe to this channel to get informed about new content like this. The Config tab allows you to override some application settings for the request only. After you enable the settings, only them will be used when preparing the request. It's time to make our first HTTP request. You can do this by focusing on any part of the HTTP editor and pressing Ctrl-Enter on Windows and Linux or Command-Enter on macOS. You can also press Enter on the URL editor or use the button to the left of the URL editor. Let's focus on the response view now. Quite literally, resize the response panel by grabbing its border. By default, only the response panel is rendered. In this panel, you see the response as it arrived from the server with the syntax highlighting. This is the most commonly used view in the application. You can right-click on the response to format it according to the response content type. In the panel's menu, you can save the request to a file or copy the contents to the clipboard. You can also clear the entire response from the view. If you want to learn about headers the server returned, then open the headers panel from the response panel's context menu. These are headers returned by the server. In case there were redirects during the request, it always shows the last response headers. You can also see the list of request headers generated by the application and the preview of the message that finally has been sent to the server. In the timings panel, you can see the timings for each part of the request process, from DNS lookup through making connection time, SSL negotiation, message sending time, waiting for the response and the response download time. You can use this information to evaluate whether the API responds in a reasonable time. The redirects panel has all information about each response that caused the redirection, like response headers, the redirect URL with the corresponding status code, and the message generated by the server. Finally, the raw panel shows the response body as it was received by the server without any processing. Before you go, please click subscribe to see more video tutorials for the application, and as always, thank you for using Advanced REST Client.